December 24th, 1996.
We've just arrived from our big trip from Tallahassee, Florida.
That's right. It should be earlier.
7 miles. It took us 4 hours and 13 minutes. Right.
It should be earlier, but it's not.
Three quarters of a tank of gas.
It is now.
We left at 2 o'clock. We arrived at, what was it, 6:03?
We drive 6:03 instead of 4:02.
It was light when we left. It was dark when we arrived. We had to stop for a full tank of gas, right? Right, Mother? So that shows how
Let's get on with the action there, Lauren.
Okay, get that tape and let's get going.
I'm
going to fall asleep.
Racers.
Racers?
That's his pet. Wow. When she goes back?
Can we say bows and counts it? I tell you, it's easy to think. I've had her pick things out.
Thank you. I swear.
She picked it out?
Well, she got
yes,
it.
Yes, I found
out. She forgot when she was when I got her.
Thanks. Yes, I remember. Man, I think. But it doesn't matter.
I
you
think,
know, dear.
I think the next present has to be for her.
Take all your ones, Lauren. That's good.
So who cares?
There you go.
That's the way it is.
Oh, thank you.
Hold it up so we can see it.
Let's see, what is it? Barbie and
the mermaid.
The mermaid. Oh, there's a
It's a marine Barbie.
Oh, I'm sorry.
That's the marine. Sheet set, cotton flannel,
oh,
too.
Oh, you'll love it.
Oh, I know, and I like that colored stuff.
Yeah.
Hi.
Yeah. Hi, Dad.
Hello, Art. It's your first attempt at filmmaking.
Yeah.
Right?
Let's see if she has Daddy's feet or his head.
Sorry, we'll show this later on at the Cannes Film Festival. Fire Chef's Director of the Year.
Right.
Well,
I think I got
what
okay,
but
I think I got
we always preface everything. So, what else?
It's
right.
True.
Polar bags.
No, that's what I said.
Show the present, Dad.
Got the paints because you see what that price is.
You can fit something else on the top.
That what you wanted?
Yeah. This is what I really wanted.
Well, I thought I heard you somebody
really?
Say
just one really? Not really, really?
Let's
see. I love doodle bears.
That's
her. Uh-huh. There you go. Two.
Hat.
Hat.
From.
Oh, I like that paper.
My head is huge.
See?
Hat.
It's still big, Mother. That brain's still growing.
We got one baby picture of me. I'm standing there all over the... like this is his face. Like this is it.
Well, you know, Suzanne's got a baby and her little head's big around like that. I said, we were talking, I said, reminds you, I said, Pat used to tease David, but I said, his head's full of brains.
Well, David
Suzanne.
Even, you know, joking.
Oh, it's cute.
His head looks like a square box.
But he always did have a little round head.
I'm so glad I got some of these. I wish you could see my socks.
She didn't know I'd gotten them.
Thank you.
You took the bow off, honey.
You don't know how much I need these.
I knew you said you needed
stuff that you
thick member.
You're all on the bottom. You're all just ruined.
You said thick member that day. I heard you say that and I thought,
perfect.
All right.
Thank you, Mother. Whose turn is it this time?
I think it's either mine or David's.
Dad!
Well, Lauren, when we get to the last, Lauren's going to be sitting set. Rap.
This one's from you to Grammy. She wrote
it. Here.
Thank you.
Here.
Thank you.
I don't know if I'm going to give you
this. Catch.
Can I give you this?
Mm-hmm.
they did you separate your paper from your pants.
It's really sweet.
I thank you.
I was not too. Isn't she hysterical when I tell you?
It is really cute.
I was telling them on the way here. It happened sort of by accident.
Thank you.
But even though it was an accident.
Do you want to tell me?
No one knows about this except a select few.
Yeah, I know how to do this, okay?
Never did I think I'd see one. I was practicing the basement with a friend the other night, and David slipped and bit me. I'm actually thinking about buying a pair of boots. I never ever thought ever in my entire life that.
This is Chris from Lauren's dad. What could it possibly be?
Yeah, Lauren, what could that be?
It looked like extra lips to the artificial tree. Is this a real tree?
It looks so real.
Yes, it does. It looks real.
It's
a
real
tree. Well, David, he introduced me. Garbage day or so. Okay. Next year you can wrap
Lauren. Like a big stuffed animal in there. Is that a big stuffed animal?
Oh well, that's how to leave, Mom.
Yeah.
Be a Bob.
They sure did. Boy, is Daddy getting fun. Yes, sir. That Taekwondo just comes in handy a lot of times. Huh?
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
Just what I wanted.
Nice.
So I can sit up in the bed, read, and I'll sit up and cramp in my neck all the time.
Isn't that terrible? Okay, you can sit on the floor.
Perfect. Thank
that
you
is
so
really
much.
Nice. You're welcome.
Those are great. Right?
I said these are the kind of presents she doesn't particularly like. But I just got these were just extra because I got them.
These are like stocking stuffer.
She wanted on the phone if I'd gotten her clothes, and I said no.
No!
She thought, well, she's holding up a show, Lauren.
No!
Is it underwear?
Yeah, can you turn up?
Well, something woke her up.
That medicine does wonders. All right. Take care of me, twins. It's yeah, I have that satellite dish for TV. They've got one. They've got about 18 music stations, and one of them is holiday music.
Uh-huh.
What is that? What's she doing?
Is that something you think you might like?
Yes. What is it? What is that? Oh my goodness! Game Boy Pocket things. You play those like in the cars and things. Play those any place you go, can't you? Those are nice.
I love these.
Play
your little Game Boy.
Ooh. I could turn there.
Okay, we'll go ahead.
All right, we need some words here.
Cuban. He is a shark.
Crosby.
He's a Crosby.
Okay. Well, it's ready.
Oh, okay. Ground. Well, he just went to go turn the ring.
Okay.
Okay. Is it taping?
Remember to say each.
Is it taping? Uh-huh. Oh my. I can't believe he did that. Most favorite thing in the whole entire world. My bike was ruined yesterday by my older sister, who didn't even ask to use it, but she did anyways. She fell 5 times, crashed 13 times, broke the spokes and wheels, and then it all collapsed on the ground. She was too far from home to walk, so she had to call from a friend's house and ask Mom to come with the car. When I heard, I was so mad! But I'm glad that she got grounded and that she had to save money for a new for me. I get the new bike, she better not try that again, or else. Okay, come on, Dad. She did that. My most favorite.
Start over.
I can't believe she did that. My most favorite thing in the whole entire world. My bike was ruined yesterday by my older sister, who didn't even ask to use it. But she did, Ace. She fell 5 times, crashed 13 times. Bent the handlebars, broke the spokes and wheels, and then it all collapsed on the ground. She was too far from home to walk, so she had to call from her friend's house and ask Mom to come with the car. When I heard, I was so mad. But I'm glad that she got grounded and that she has to save money for a new bike from me. And when I get the new bike, she better not try that again. Else.
Good. Why don't you go ahead and try it again while you're filming, okay? Oh. Did much better that time.
I snapped about it. Is it still saving?
Mm-hmm.
Oh god. Oh gosh. Grounded. I can't believe she did that. Most favorite thing in the whole entire world. My bike was ruined yesterday. I can't believe she did that. My most favorite thing in the whole entire world. My bike was ruined yesterday by my older sister, who didn't even ask to use it. But she did anyways. But she fell 5 times, crashed 13 times, bent the handlebars, broke the spokes and wheels. And then it all collapsed on the ground. When I heard, I was so mad. I was glad that she got grounded and that she has to save money for a new bike for me. And when I get the new bike, she better not try that again. And Dad will let that apart.
Let's try again. What happened? Remember, you stomped?
Okay.
Let's try again. Just each one of them say, just clear.
Grounded. I can't believe she did that! Most fat. Grounded. I'm in a serious mood here, okay, guys? I can't believe she did that! My most favorite thing in the whole entire world! My bike, was joined yesterday by my older sister, who didn't even ask to use it, but she did anyways. She fell 5 times and crashed 13 times. The handlebars broke the spokes and wheels, and then it all collapsed on the ground. She was too far from home to walk, so she had to call from a friend's house and ask Mom to come with the car. When I heard, I was so mad, but I'm glad that she got grounded and that she has to save money for a new bike from me. When I get the new bike, she better not try that again, or else.
Hey, that was your best one. That was good.
Thanks, Dad!
My bike.
It's ready.
Wait, I want to tell you a story now, okay? Grounded.
I can't believe she did that! My most favorite thing in the entire world. My bike was ruined yesterday by my older sister, who didn't even ask to use it. But she did anyways. Anyway, she fell 5.
Go back, son. Okay. She fell.
Okay. I'm gonna start all over again.
Okay.
I can't believe she did that. My most favorite thing in the whole entire world. My bike. I can't believe she did that. I can't believe she did that.
Start over.
I'm sorry. I can't believe she did that. My most favorite thing in the whole entire world. My bike was ruined yesterday by my older sister, who didn't even ask to use it, but she did anyways. She fell 5 times, crashed 13 times, I can't believe she did that. My most favorite thing in the whole entire world, my bike was ruined yesterday by my older sister, who didn't even ask to use it, but she did anyways. Anyway, I can't believe she did that. My most favorite thing on the whole entire world, my bike was ruined yesterday by my older sister, who didn't even ask to use it, but she did anyway. She fell 5 times, crashed 13 times, bent the handlebars, broke the spokes and wheels, and then it all collapsed on the ground. She was too far from home to walk, so she had to call from a friend's house and asked Mom to come with the car. When I heard, I could chop off her neck. I was so mad. But I'm glad that she got grounded and that she has to save money for a new bike for me. When I get the new bike, she better not try that again. Else. Good job.
That was good.
I can't believe she did that. My most favorite thing in the whole entire world. My bike was ruined yesterday by my older sister, who didn't even ask to use it. But she did anyways. She fell 5 times, crashed 13 times, broke the spokes and wheels. And then it all collapsed on the ground. She was too far from home to walk, so she had to call from a friend's house and ask Mom to come with the car. When I heard, I was so mad! But I'm glad that she got grounded and that she has to save money for a new bike for me. And when I get the new bike, she better not try that again. Or else.
It's on.
Didn't even ask to use it, but she did anyways. She fell 5 times. She fell off 5 times. Crashed 13 times. Bent the handlebars. Broke the spokes wheels. Then it all collapsed on the ground. She was too far from home to walk, so she had to call from her friend's house and ask Mom to come in the car. When I heard, I was so mad! But I'm glad that she got grounded and that she has to save money for a new bike for me. When I get the new bike, she better not drive it again, or else.
Very, very good. Lauren eating a hamburger. Oh, look at the camera, just do it.
I'm so glad all of you. list. Oh dear, Marshall's assured me. Some Duchess got overlooked.
One of us.
One of you? Oh my, terrible. You passed the word along, didn't you? Is she angry?
Point her out to me.
Oh, sure, we said 12 invitations.
You did. There are 13 of us.
13? That's rather unlucky, isn't it?
You can say that again. Alicia has lived alone for years. No wonder you forgot her. We would like to, but...
If she comes, she might be a bit angry.
Thank you for letting me know. I'd better get back to the guests.
Well, 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 what merit! Thank you for letting me come. Oh, but you did it, did you? No matter.
Who is she? She's a forgotten fairy. Let me handle this. Alicia? I'm so sorry. It's a dreadful oversight. We're thrilled that you are here. Aren't we, everyone?
Would you like a plate?
I'm not hungry. I'm here to dower the princess with the I brought for her.
Your face is so pale.
What can you possibly have to fear?
I will begin. My gift to Briar Rose is beauty. None shall surpass her in loveliness. I give her virtue. Her beauty is nothing without goodness of heart. She shall sing like a nightingale. She will have a bountiful sense of humor.
After beauty, wit, the princess should be more clever than any mortal could ever hope to be, and she shall dance as lightly as a feather.
She shall speak any language that she chooses. She should be graceful.
She will play any musical instrument she chooses.
Have you all finished?
Here it is,
Monarch.
On the day that she reaches her 15th birthday, the princess shall prick her finger with the spindle of a spinning wheel and shall immediately die.
No, have pity. God on her dreadful fate on my head, but don't harm an innocent child.
It is done.
Be comforted. My wish is still to come, as far as I can. I will undo this mischief that my sister has done. I do not have the power to prevent altogether what she has decreed, but instead of dying, she shall fall into a deep sleep, and that sleep shall last for 100 years. When that time is past, a king's son shall come and wake her.
Thank you all.
Majesty, perhaps you might consult my secret books.
Secret books?
Hogwash.
I'll have you know that they were written by Merlin himself.
What could you accomplish?
Well, possibly there is a way to keep the people asleep.
Consult your books, Montrose. It's our only hope.
Princess, an enchanted ring for?
No.
Turn into calm with any member of the family? Left over in the party.
Thank you, cook.
What? These are the secret books? Why, there must be 500 pages of the princesses alone.
500.
What? You just look under and sleep.
Do you mind?
Sleep. Preventing people from falling asleep. We found it, cook! Oh dear. Only for use on the good stepmothers who have shamefully ill-used their stepchildren.
We must
send out a proclamation. Here. Whereas a certain malicious fairy, forgetful of the duty she owes to the king and queen and the princess Briar Rose, etc., etc.
Thank you.
kidding.
Thank you.
light on. Yep.
Don't race the turtles.
Oh.
store for the next 3 days, Wolf. Tomorrow perfect, the day after tomorrow perfect, and the day after that. You guessed it, perfect.
Sounds perfectly perfect to me, Wolf.
Maybe somebody will write a fable using weather terms instead of animals, like the Nimbus and the Cyclone. Oh well, back to you, Chef and Prudence.
Thanks, Wolf. Our stories are one that Aesop might have told if he were alive today, and sitting in the back of the class, daydreaming, goofing around instead of paying attention like he was supposed to.
Or, if Dobby the Rabbit did have time to run out and buy more paper over again when the bus picked him up again.
Anyway, we found some beastly fables with fresh moments for you.
And they're all about kinds of bosses, sneaky, funny, annoying, dimple people.
But no one we know, personally.
Really?
Let's turn over to our star reporter, Patty Patience.
Thanks, Chef. I have with me Elephant and Mosquito. Apparently, they were out late last night and lost and completely lost track of time. Elephant, can you tell me what happened?
Yes, we were at the restaurant having a great time, and I guess I just forgot to get a car.
Hey, we were having fun. Who cares what time it is?
I do, because my parents wanted me to be home at 10 o'clock.
Where?
No, Mosquito, there's no need for that.
When I finally did see a clock and it was already 10:20, I knew my parents would kill me. So I looked around for a shuttle. And I said, "Why bother? We'll be home in 5 minutes."
So you didn't call?
No, ma'am.
And what happened when you got home?
My parents greeted me for a week.
There you have it. And the moral is,
never listen to a talking bird.
This just in, breaking news from the water ring.
What is it, Wolf?
Hey, on the size of grapefruit. Huh. And guess what? Everyone must take cover immediately.
I hope that was not one of them.
on. The phone rang and I was the only one home, so I went to answer it. I tried to say I'm very grown up, just like my mom taught me. Hello, Walrus residence. That's very good. Then who's on the phone? It was my mom's friend Will. He wanted to know if she was home. And what did you say? Having the hair taken off of her lip. Ouch! Back to you in the studio.
And tomorrow is.
Tomorrow, that one is. It's always tough.
But if your mom is out having the hair taken off her lip, you might want to forget a few of the details. Now
BC.
Tintana, and the musical octave was introduced for the first time. This all happens in and around 600 BC.
Nita, Chef, what's left in tonight's broadcast?
Well, I'm afraid we're winding now, just a few more to go. We're going back to check on Elephant with his friend Mosquito. Watch closely.
Wow, that was a great movie. What time is it?
Yeah, I love the part when the guy on the top of the building came in.
Mosquito, what time is it?
Oh, it's 11 o'clock.
Oh, no, I was supposed to be home an hour ago. I better call. Where's the phone?
Why bother? Mrs. Elephant is sure I'm escaping, and I'll just wait for if you call.
You're right, I'll just get home when I can.
Uh-oh, I bet Miss Elephant's furious.
She certainly was, and she never forgot. And the moral is...
never listen. And remember that other story I'm talking about. Hours call home.
Before we wrap up for tonight, Fox is here to give us a preview of what's to come on the show tomorrow.
Yes, on tomorrow's show, we have Slowfish!
Okay, bye.
joining us tonight.
I'm Janine Deverly.
I'm Chef Shepherd.
And I'm Wolf Pryor.
Until next time,
get your story straight.
Always remember to change the name.
Then name their names and so go to a point.
Marry Our Play Is, the most lamentable comedy and most the pyramids.
A very good piece of work, I assure you. And a Mary. Now then, Peter Quince, call forth the actors by the roll. Masters, spread yourselves.
Enter as I call you. Nick Bottom, the weaver.
Ready. Name what part I inform, proceed.
You, Nick Bottom, are set down for pyramids.
What is Pyramus, a lover or a tyrant?
A lover that kills himself most gallant for love.
That will ask some tears in the true performing of it. If I do it, let the audience look to their eyes. I will move storms, I will condole in some measure. And to the rest, my chief humor is for a tyrant. I could play Heracles rarely, or part to tear a cat in, to make all split. The raging rocks and shimmering shocks that break the locks of prison gates, and Phoebus' car shall shine from afar and make him mar the foolish fates. This was lofty. Now name the rest of the players. This was Heracles' vein, a tyrant's vein, a lover's more condoling.
Anyway. Francis, flute the bellows mender.
Here, Peter Quince.
Flute, you must take Thisbe on you.
What is Thisbe, a wandering knight?
It is the lady that Pyramus must love.
Nay, please make me not play a woman. I have a bird coming.
That's all one. You shall play to the mast, and you may speak as small as you will.
Let me hide my face, and I may play Thisbe too. I'll speak in a monstrous little voice.
Ah, Pyramus, my lover dear, and Thisbe dear, and lady dear.
No, you must play Pyramus. And flute, you Thisbe. Robin Starveling the tailor.
Here, points.
Robin Starveling, you must play Thisbe's mother. Tom Snout the tinker.
Here, Peter Quince.
You must play Pyramus's father. Myself, Thisbe's father. Snog the joiner, you the lion's part, and I hope here is a play fitted.
Thou speakest? All right. I am that mirror wonder of night.
I just to O'Brien and make him smile, when I a fat and bean a fed horse beguile, nay, in likeness of a filly foal, and sometimes I lurk in a gossip's bow, in very likeness of a roasted crab. And when she drinks against her lips I bob, the withered dewlap pour the ale, and sometimes the saddest tale being told by the saddest lady.
What thou seest when thou dost wake, do it for thy true love. Love and languish for his sake, be it ounce or cat or mare, hard or boar with bristled hair, in thine eyes shall appear. When thou wakest, it is thy gear. Wake when something vile is here.
A play there is, my lord, some 10 words long, which is as brief as I know to play, but by 10 words, my lord,
tis brief sing of young Pyramus and his love Thisbe, a very tragical mirth. Merry and tragical, tedious and brief, who then did you play it?
Hard-handed men that work in Athens here, which never labor their minds till now.
And I will hear it.
No, my noble lord, it is not for you. I have heard it over, and it is nothing.
I will hear that play, whenever anything can be amiss. The simplest and duty tender it. Go, bring them in, and take your places, ladies.
I love not to see wretchedness o'ercharged, and duty in his service perishing.
Why, little sweet, you shall see no such thing.
He says there can be nothing in this kind.
The kind are we, to give him thanks for nothing.
So please, your grace, the prologue is addressed.
Let him approach.
And Thisbe, carrying in mulberry shade, his dagger drew, and
wall, and lovers twain at large discourse, well, here they do remain.
What if the lion beat his beak?
No one, my lord. One lion may, when many asses do.
In this same manner, lord, it doth befall that I, once now by name, present a wall, and such a wall as I might have you think, that had in it a crannied hole or chink, through which lovers, Pyramus and Thisbe, did whisper often, very secretly. This loam, this rough cast, this stone doth show that I am that same wall. The truth is so. Here the cranny is, right and sinister, through which the lovers are to whisper.
You desire lime and hair to speak better?
It is the wittiest partition that ever I heard discourse, my lord.
Pyramus draweth near the wall. Silence.
Oh, grim-looked night! Oh, night with hue so black! Oh, night, whichever art when day is not! Oh, night, alack, alack, alack! I fear my Thisbe's promises, but thou wall, O wall, O sweet, O lovely wall, which stands between her father's house and mine, thou wall, O sweet, O lovely wall, show me thy cheek that I may blink through with mine eye. Thanks, courteous wall, Jove shield thee well for this. But what see I? No Thisbe do I see. Oh, wicked wall through whom I see no bliss. Curse be thy stones for deceiving me thus.
The wall methinks being sensible should curse again.
No, sir, indeed he should not. Deceiving me is Thisbe's cue. She is to enter now, and I'm inspired through the wall. You see a wall fall.
must get back to him. Oh, there you are, sleeping easily. Oh, goodness, I was so afraid.
Get away.
Get away, carrots, huh?
Thank you.
is now a friendship?
No, thank you.
Will you not even tell us your name?
I cannot.
Then it seems to us you have come for the child.
I must tell the truth. I have indeed come for the child. It was by my carelessness that you found her unguarded, and that her father and mother weep for the loss of her.
Why so should I weep into the child from us?
And I would be sad too, little cat, to lack your company through the long winter evening, through the long winter evenings. Will you not drink with us now and forget the past? Judgment and we will abide by it.
We do know him, my lord. The child is not lost. Because you have given us your power over them, the child and the little cat will come to you and share with the knights along. Yet you shall not bind it with your magic. And when the first evil cat comes dancing away, they shall return unto the green hill and flow on their own. Then I shall see the child again.
We are very satisfied. Thank you. I will see you next year, Catkin. New riddles.
My lord, we can't linger. Goodbye.
Bye.
Bye.
looks like you're out of luck, Ty.
Yeah, I guess you struck out.
Ty, I'm here for 10 minutes. We've got to go.
Boo!
What?
Will you stop it? I never thought I'd see a Mighty Ty Bear in the library after you hit that ball through the window last year.
Shh! It wasn't an accident. Besides, they were nice about it.
Sure, after Mom and Dad dragged you here to admit you did it, they're probably watching you like a hawk.
Any luck?
Nope, all the famous baseball players want your checks out. No Pete Rose, no Pete Griffey Jr., no Mickey Mantle, no Willie Mays.
Not even a lousy book on Cal Ripken. Erica's writing about him.
Who? Young man.
Me? Window breaker.
Does the report have to be on a real baseball player?
Well, no. I don't know. I guess not.
Then this does not work. He's very famous, but it's fictional.
That means made up.
I know what it means.
Huh?
Can't you get the bat?
Right.
Look how thin this is. Like when we didn't know, Tom.
And when the dust had lifted, and the men saw what had occurred,
to
catcher was a Jimmy safe at second. And Flynn the Hawk in third.
Then from 5,000 throats and more, there rose a lusty yell.
It rumbled in the beach.
It rattled in the dell.
It knocked upon the mountain. It coiled upon the flat.
For Casey.
Marty Casey.
Was advancing to the bat.
There was an ease in Casey's manner as he stepped into his place.
There was pride in Casey's bearing and a smile on Casey's face.
And then respond.
Then responding to the cheers, he lightly ducked his hat.
No stranger in the crowd could doubt.
Was Casey at the bat?
10,000 eyes were on him.
As he rubbed his hands dirt.
5,000 times applauding.
When he wiped them on his shirt.
And now the rising pitcher got the ball into the chip.
Defiance.
Gleamed in Casey's eye.
A sneer.
Curled Casey's lip.
Now the leather-covered sphere.
And now the leather-covered sphere that moved through the air.
And Casey stood watching in the hide of Brenda there.
Close by the sturdy batsman, the ball and heated sped.
Close by the sturdy batsman, the ball and heated sped.
That ain't my style, said Casey.
Strike one color, said.
From the benches blocking people, there was up a muffled roar.
Like the beating of the storm through the distant shore.
Kill him! Kill the umpire!
Shouted someone in the stands.
And it's likely they'd have killed him.
And now Casey raised his hand.
With a smile of Christian charity, great Casey's visage shone.
He stilled the rising tumult. He bade the game go on.
He signaled through the pitcher, and went toward the sphere I flew.
But Casey still ignored it.
Strike. And umpire said strike two.
Fry!
Cried the mad in thousands. An echo answered,
Fry!
One scornful look from Casey.
And the audience was on. They saw his face go stunning cold. They saw his muscles strike.
And they knew that Casey
wouldn't let the ball go by again.
His teeth are clenched with pain.
He pounds with cruel violence, his bat upon the plate. And now holds the ball.
And now he lets it go. And now the air is shattered by the force of Casey's blow.
All right, Casey.
It's summer in this favorite land, the sun is shining bright.
And somewhere the band is playing, and somewhere hearts are light.
And somewhere men are laughing,
and somewhere children shout,
and there is no joy.
Wait a minute. Hey, it can't end this way. You're supposed to be a hero. You struck out. You blew it. This is the most depressing thing I've ever read. Maybe there's a secret. What's the use?
What's your problem?
Nothing.
Are you still thinking about that Casey guy? Ty, it was just a book. Not even a book. A poem. Get over it.
Yeah, I know. But you heard what Nadine said about Casey sounding familiar.
She was just joking.
I'm going to strike out. I know it. I'll walk up to the plate. Everybody will cheer, and then I don't feel so good.
This is just great. Read it.
Teacher,
she's reading
it from
your mind, but look what happens.
Bye, Ty.
Come on in, guys. We better warm up anyway.
I'm really excited. This is going to be a great game.
What makes you think so?
Because I like baseball, don't you?
Mandy, you think I'm a jerk?
Sure, sometimes.
Great.
Ty, you're not Casey at the bat. You're not a folk hero. Nobody thinks you're the best player on the team, except you. 5,000 people don't even live in this town, let alone come to these games. I'd count the crowd at 63 times yours.
Yeah, no, that's what I mean. After I did the report, I realized I spent the whole season acting like a big shot. Everybody else played great, too.
So you think you deserve to strike out like some weird punishment?
It's fate.
I like you, Ty, but you're a nut.
Play ball!
This is great. 4-2, just like that Casey story. Bet it's a double.
That would be great.
Right at the bottom there.